Hey, it's Luke here, just video blogging again. This week I want to talk about what God's been working on me about in my quiet time. Seems he wants me to work on my character, specifically my true character. You know, who I am when no one's around. And oh boy, did he have some tests for me right off the bat. It all started when I got to school early and I went into the classroom to hang up my coat and I walked right past Bubba's desk. No, that's not his real name. I call him that to protect the guilty. Remember a few months ago when I video blogged about my stolen gummy bears? Well, I just know Bubba stole them. How? Maybe it was that smirk on his face when he was chewing something. Maybe it was the crinkling noise under his desk during the spelling test. Or maybe it's just that he's the lowest low-down good-for-nothing fourth grader in the school who's always up to no good. Well, anyway, I'm walking by his desk, and there's a bag of gummy bears that looks exactly like the bag stolen from me. Now, I know it's not my bag. Not even a thief like Bubba would still have my bag. I'm sure they were eaten long ago. But this is my chance to re-steal them back. I mean, this is God returning them to me, right? It's justice right there for the taking. I look both ways, and there's no one around. I reach out, and then I remember. Character is who you are when no one's looking. And then I also remember that God is looking. Man, if I want to be holy, I've got to do what is right and pleases God, even if no one is around, and even if I have a good excuse. So I didn't take the gummy bears. I was feeling pretty good about myself. I had passed the gummy bear test. Whew! God must be proud of me. I had shown myself to be a kid of character. And then, it happened again. This time it was recess. I ran back inside to get my frisbee to toss around with my buddies. When I saw it, I was walking past the teacher's desk. Now, I wasn't trying to snoop or anything. He practically jumped up and poked me in the eye. But I saw it. A folder on her desk that said, Big, Fat, Hairy, Evil Test. And it had a skull and crossbones on it. Okay, maybe I'm exaggerating a little. Okay, a lot. It just said pop quiz. But it might as well have had a skull and crossbones on it. A pop quiz is like poison to a kid. I gotta admit, it was all I could do not to open that folder and look inside. I wanted to peek and see if I could memorize a few of the questions and answers, or at least see what subject it was so I could study for it. But I remembered that I'm working on my true character and who I am when no one's looking. So I kept on walking, and I got out of there as fast as I could. I knew I would just have to be diligent and study everything and hope to do well in that pop quiz. But just knowing there was a pop quiz didn't really seem fair. None of the other kids knew. So after school, I wondered if I had done something wrong by even looking on her desk. So I fessed up. And it turns out it was for another class. Praise the Lord! So far, so good. I was feeling really good about my character. But things were about to get worse. Much worse. I'm lucky to even be here making this video to tell you the truth. After school, I'm walking by the flagpole toward the bus, and I see this alien picking on a poor little first grader. Okay, maybe he wasn't an alien, but he could have been. I mean, no sixth grader could have muscles that big naturally. Maybe he was on steroids or something. But before I knew what was happening, it was like I was watching it rather than doing it. But next thing I knew, I'm between the little kid and the bully, and these death wish words are coming out of my mouth. Hey, buddy, pick on someone your own size. And no sooner had I said those words when I made a terrible realization. I am his size. So I just closed my eyes and prepared for the worst. And after what seemed like an eternity, I peeked and he was gone. I think maybe his mothership picked him up. Then the little tyke said, "You're my hero." You know, it reminded me of 2 Corinthians 16:9, where God says, "For the eyes of the Lord range about the earth, to strengthen those whose hearts are fully committed to him." Since I've been having the character to follow after God, he gave me the courage to stand up to that bully, and then he protected me. I guess I'm doing okay with this character thing after all.
Luke!
Yeah, Dad?
Have you taken out the garbage?
Not yet, Dad.
Do I have to be watching you in order for you to do the right thing?
Sorry, Dad. I'll come do it. Well, I guess my character still needs some work after all. I gotta go. Bye.